Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm going to be doing an interesting project. Specifically, I'm going to be making a couple of videos in Unreal World version 3.4. The reason being is that when I made the impressions video, I had to condense a lot of the information in this game into a short, less than a half hour, less than 40 minutes video. And there is a lot in this game, and there's a lot of things to talk about. A little more than what would be for just a short video, but I was able to do so. However, I want to make a couple of videos expanding everything about it. So this is going to be like a tutorial on Unreal World. I'm not going to be showing you how to completely, you know, play through the entire game, mind you. I'm just going to be showing you a number of the aspects in Unreal World. In any case, let us create a character, because you can't exactly start a game without a character. Now, there are a couple of options. The quick and easy is basically just telling the game to pick a character however they want to and plop you into the Unreal world. Custom, these three options basically allows you to customize your character. However, these two just makes it a little easier for you to create your character, because it allows you to add a little more benefits if you really want to do it like that. For now, I'm just going to be doing the regular old custom. And for the name, I'm going to be using Tutara, which is kind of a play on tutorial. These many cultures we have right here dictate how our character is designed, and how their stats are employed, and how their skills are employed. Well, it just tells us how, which one, it just tells us what their perks are at the beginning, how high of their early stats they're going to be, and how other stats are going to require a little more training. For example, the character that I showed in my impressions is the Drikaleanin. They are the Drikaleans. They trade with independence, with fishermen from time to time. They're attacked. They have differentiated professions, merchants, soldiers, sailors, and so on. So, in my opinion, the Drikalea set is like the everyman, because they could be whenever they need to be in a certain situation. They're a bit of a, like a jack of all trades. Their stats are basically well-rounded, somewhat. Now, for this, what do I want to choose? Islanders, if I remember correctly. They live on fishing and hunting seals and birds. They are skilled carpenters. Actually, no. I think I'll stick with Drikaleanin. Because, you know, all-arounders are really not that bad. Because it gives you a little option. It gives you the option to, fashion their character more and to improve on some of their skills. This guy looks like he's got a hangnail. This character's face will do. Now, we have four seasons to start with. Summer is the easiest because the snow is already melted, and there's a lot of stuff you can do to prepare for the oncoming winter. Autumn is second easiest because it's harvest season, and you can start to collect resources from the various areas. Winter is basically the hardest because it's the beginning of when things start to snow, and you're gonna be, well, starting to struggle. Spring is second hardest because it's starting to melt. The snow is starting to melt, sort of. But it gives you a sort of time to prepare for the summer. It's kind of like a preparations period. If you know how to handle yourself, you can basically start off at spring, which is what I'm going to be starting off as. Let's see, stat-wise? Ooh, no. I don't want that much strength and that much endurance. Strength is the ability to handle strength-based abilities, and there are going to be a lot of stuff that requires us to be using our strength a lot. Endurance is how much we can carry, and seeing as my endurance is very low, yeah, I'm not going to be able to carry a whole lot, and that's going to be a bad thing, especially when I'm going to be going around carrying a lot of stuff. Now, I want to make the stats a little balanced. Just a fair bit of endurance. That one had a good bit of endurance, but low strength. No. Yeah, I think this'll do. Endurance, strength, those are really up there, so that's a good start. General Sacrifice, Hunter's Request to Catch a Fox. Well, General Sacrifice is always a good thing because it... when you sacrifice a fish or meat, the spirits will, well, be happy. And making the spirits happy is one way to be able to access more rituals. And more rituals mean more abilities to, you know, please the spirits, to make effective use of... they're basically a way of giving yourself buffs and healing yourself a little. Like, making sure you don't bleed, or healing yourself. Alright. What I want to do is... I want to have a good axe skill. Mainly because... when you start off, you always have an axe. Because you're going to be chopping trees, so axes is going to be an all-rounder tool, as well as a knife. But I'm going to be choosing an axe for this. Spears are things you can create, craft, and whatnot. To be honest, these are basically going to be used for, you know, piercing. Because an axe isn't going to have the piercing power. And if you're going to be fighting people, you're going to have... to have some variety. Actually, now that I think about it... yeah. Also, you're gonna have some spears that you can actually throw, which is actually good, because if you have throwing spears, you can actually hit animals from far away if you're hunting. Bows, I have not exactly found any real use for, because more often than not, when you're taking time to load another arrow to shoot, the animal will have probably ran away further and further until they're gone. More often than not, you're probably gonna hope for that first shot kill. Let's see, swimming, don't have to worry too much about that. Unless you want to learn how to swim, you're going to be using a raft or a punt, a boat of some sort. Climbing and stealth are abilities that can be easily improved on, so don't bother putting any points into those. That, you don't want to do any climbing early on anyways, until you max it out. Mainly because if you fall down and you have no armor, you're going to hurt yourself, and that's going to affect your skills. Let's see. I want to improve my carpentry skills, because that makes better carpentry stuff. Trapping, because I want to be able to trap better. Timbercraft, that's basically chopping down trees, turning things into smaller lumber. That actually isn't something you need to worry about, because you can train that one easily enough. Hideworking is the same thing as well, but if you want to have goods to barter, it's kind of a valuable skill to train up, just not early on. herb lore, you want to train up a bit, because the more herb lore you have, the more you'll be able to recognize certain herbs. Actually, you know what? Leave herb lore alone, because you're gonna find a lot of herbs, and you're gonna be able to easily train those very quickly. So, which ones do I really want to boost here? Well, Physician is a good ability to train up because, well, to have an early training on, or having a higher ritual skill, because sometimes, if I remember right, from what I've read, ritual has certain effects with certain rituals, like with the ability to fish. If you use the ritual for fishing, you'll have a higher chance of getting more fish. At least that's how I read it. Of course, you don't really need to have a high enough ritual, because once you've trained everything up, you don't really need to have a lot of ritual. So, let's actually go with Physician, because if you're gonna get hurt, you might as well have at least a competent amount of healing skill. It's not exactly a easy skill to train up it anyways, because you would have to hurt yourself intentionally to heal yourself. There are a number of ways to injure yourself, but it takes a while to actually heal yourself completely. Let's see. That real red block there is where we will start. To be honest, that's not exactly where I want to start, because that is somewhere up in the mountains, and, well, I don't really like that I'm far away from any water. Which would mean I'd have to start traveling to find some sort of lake or river or of some sort. Let's see. Change my start location. Now that's an interesting place to start, but no. Problem is, that means I'm starting off at an island. Sure, I have a lot of water and I would have a constant source of food, but I am far away from any civilization. Yes, there are gonna be some vagabond civilizations, but to be honest, I want to be somewhere close to a culture. The Owl Tribe? No. I want to at least start near the middle, where the key says. How about here, though? Well, there's a lot of dense trees there, but actually, I think I can make a use of it. I see a little hook right there in the southeast. Let's see. And there's actually another one a little northeastern of that. And if I want to, I could set up camp there. Or set up on one of the islands around there. Yes, this will be a good start, and I'm near the Koivula, and that's acceptable. I'm also near the Dreek, and the Dreeks are, they're merchants, so they're gonna have a lot of goods to purchase from. So, yeah, I think this will be a good start point. Of course, I can start within my home culture if I really want to, but no, I think this will be a good point to start off at. Now we have a startup scenario. These things will give you bonuses or detriments. Like, wanting to be a fisherman, giving you a good set of fishing equipment. Or there'd be robbers or you know, hurt, helpless, and afraid, or, you know, escaped, let's see, runaway slave. Yeah. For this, I want to be a fisherman because it's at the beginning of... I chose spring, so I'm gonna need to have some fishing equipment to begin with. Which will allow me to be able to have some sort of passive way of fishing up, passive way of fishing up, you know, food. Because food is gonna be important. Here we have a bit of a scenario information, you know, telling you about, you know, about, it gives you a bit of a backstory to go with, if you really want to. Let us select the scenario, and we have a game course. Choosing these game courses just gives you a bit of a tutorial, and they do give you some perks. Like, at a certain point, you'll get a fishing rod. That's not to say it's going to render your being a fisherman redundant, because that's not going to give you a fishing net. And fishing nets are the more effective tool. Also, it'll give you a hand axe. If for some reason you don't start off with a sufficient, you know, axe of some type. A hand axe is the all-around tool, but if you don't, you're going to have to start off with making a crude one. And crude ones aren't exactly all that great. For now, I'm gonna go with the regular, you know, Unreal World, but you can activate those tutorials whenever you want in the game. Okay. Let's load the map up, see what we have for our inventory. Fine hunting knife, a woodsman's axe. Oh, that's good for chopping down trees. We got a spear to start with. Very nice. Nail trousers, woolen undershirt, woolen tunic. Well, that just means we're not exactly, well, prepared for cold stuff. So we're probably going to have to be prepared for that. We do have a fishing rod and two nets, which is actually what we get with. A torch is something probably start off as random. And a set of foods. The one thing we need to eat up first is the roasted capercaillie cuts, because roasted foods, they spoil faster than smoked bear cuts. In any case, I actually want to go to that archipelago before we end this bit of the tutorial. And I'm starting to get cold. Let's see. Well, we found one settlement. That's one of the that's the first one we saw. So we have to go a little further. But before we do that, I need to zoom in and I need to warm myself up, because if I don't, I'm gonna freeze to death. And that'll be a quick end to this tutorial. Move this here. Prepare a fire. And I'm gonna chop down this tree. Move one of these trunks. And push it into the fire. There we go. Now I want to make sure I'm nice and sweaty before I continue onward. Because the warmer I am, the less I have to worry about having to set another fire. Okay. I'm nice and sweaty, so let us continue onward. First things first, though, I want to make sure I have... I want to have some kindling and one of these trunks on me. So that way I have a fire to prepare when I make my, when I reach my, camp of choice. Let's zoom out. Let's see, it's a little it's a little more northeast, if I remember correctly. No, that's not it. Although it actually is a little nice, but it's not it. I need to eat. No, this isn't it. Oh, there's another mountain. Okay, I need to get something to drink. I'm getting a little thirsty. So I'm gonna go near this lake, poke up in a hole in the water. Come on. Okay. Drink up. Eat my bread. And I'm gonna set a fire here. And I'm going to prepare another set of kindling. It's getting dark, so I don't exactly want to continue traveling while it's dark. Nope. There we go. This time, let's grab all the trees. Alright, now it's early morning. We can continue onwards. Things will start getting brighter, so we can actually see farther. There's a hill over there. Okay, I need to eat something. There we go. I believe our little shop is gonna be right up here. Yep, here it is. Here's where we are going to set up shop. With that in mind, I'm gonna choose a little place in the corner here. I'm going to chop down a tree. First things first, I want to grab some kindling. Chop this down. Build a shelter, because you need to have some sort of shelter for when it starts to snow or rain, until you manage to make yourself a more long-lasting shelter. Gotta rest. Alright. Let us drop our resources here. Not those trunks, though. Seeing as we have our nice new home right here, I'm going to be, yes, this is going to be a good start. So, with that in mind, this is going to be the end of the first part of Unreal World's tutorial, which is basically creating a character and finding a home you want to start up at. With that in mind, the next part is we're going to figure out what we're going to do for the next part. With that in mind, I am Melcadrien, and this has been a tutorial for Unreal World. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr if you want to. I do however appreciate it. Thank you. You all have a wonderful day, and happy gaming.